This is Mia, and we are here with singer-songwriter Kaci Battaglia.
Hello.
Hello. Thank you for joining us. She actually came on a red-eye flight and still looks this gorgeous. I mean, she got, what, 1 hour of sleep?
I think maybe two, an hour and a half or something. You're going and going and going on 2 hours, and then all of a sudden you sleep for eight. The next day...
crash.
Oh my god, your body's like, that is such a tease. You know, why did you do that to me? So I try not to actually sleep 8 hours until I get home and I can actually have 2 or 3 days to myself.
Yeah, that's important.
Yeah.
How do you kind of refresh yourself when you're, you know, out on the road and then you go back home? Obviously sleep, but...
Well, see, I'm kind of a workaholic on the road, so when I get home, I act like a lazy bum and love every second of it. But potato couch, you know, or couch potatoes. That's how you know that, A, you're really, really sleepy, and B, you're probably dyslexic. When I was little, I was very shy and like, oh my gosh, and, you know, the boys used to come up and kind of... try to
that's
play rough
they
with
you.
Well, that's what they say.
Yeah.
Which is so screwed up. I mean, if you like somebody, don't you want to treat them well? It's like that movie. Like, did you see that? The one.
The one movie where the guy treats the woman badly.
That one. Oh, come on! It's a chick flick that just came out. Anyway. That's what they said at the beginning. Like, how screwed up is it that you get it stuck in your head from a young age if a guy's jerk to you that they like you?
Yeah.
Anyway. It's a good movie. You should watch it when you figure out what it is.
I'm going to go on IMDb right now when
put
I get
in the quote.
Back and, yeah, and see what happened. It probably starred Kate Hudson or something like that.
What were we just talking about? Yes, I was very shy, and my mom decided that she would put me in self-defense, so I started doing karate.
Okay.
And I did that for a few years, became like, you know, went up in belts, and then left after a couple years because music takes me away from everything, basically. Uh-huh. Music has always kind of stolen me. So I went off and did my thing, and finally I came home at like 14 in Florida and just decided, you know, I miss it. I want to get back into it. And I think it's a great way to become fit and to learn how to defend yourself at the same time. And it's just really positive. So I started doing it then and got really into it. I studied like 3 hours a day, 6 days a week. And yeah.
Wow.
I was whooping, just killing the bags. So I just kind of naturally became an instructor at that point. Yeah.
That's crazy. So you were talking a little bit about you went...
with Jim Graydon, by the way.
With what?
Jim Graydon was the guy who taught me. I have to give a shout out to him because he's awesome.
So. What's up, Jim?
What's up, Jim?
So, yeah, you were talking a little bit about or hinting at the fact that music took you away. I know that at 13, you were, like, touring with Backstreet Boys, Jessica Simpson. What was that like?
Pretty nutty. I mean, it's basically what it is now, just at 13. I was kind of a little bit more oblivious until,
sure.
You know, but I was very fortunate to have 3 top 10 hits when I was 13 overseas. So that was where all the fun was, really, was
right.
Overseas. So I basically lived over there for a few years and
wow.
I had this crazy whirlwind of a life and then came back to reality and it was like, whoa. Normal?
Yeah, you took a bit of a...
So different.
You took a bit of a break, but, I mean, did you ever really go back to normal, having had all that experience?
Absolutely did.
So your friends were back there?
Well, yeah, you can imagine, if you homeschool and you're working the whole time, you really don't have so many friends. You have work colleagues, maybe?
Right.
you know?
That's my life right now.
Right? Like, yeah. Everything's work. So in a good way and in kind of a bad way. So when I went home making friends and really discovering who I was and how to deal with life on a social level, mm-hmm. It's like I could run a meeting at 13, but put me at a playground or whatever was normal at 13 in a mall dealing with boy drama,
mm-hmm.
And I didn't know how to handle it because I wasn't around it. And it's funny being, you know, 18, even 18, 19 years old, knowing full well that you're going through something for the first time that people went through 5 years
sure.
ago.
Yeah.
Knowing that you're responding emotionally and immaturely, logically thinking this, it's still having the same response because it's such a shocker, you know?
Yeah.
And I was very shy, kind of, not shy, but very like, you know, wide-eyed about things that you just would think were totally normal, you know? So now I'm glad that I'm having success today as opposed
right.
to when I was a child because I have a much better sense of who I am and what to expect out of life and people and social situations.
So tell me about your album. I already have Crazy Possessive in my head,
yeah.
The single, which is great. And I wanted to know actually if your kickboxing helped you, the aggressiveness of that helped you with the song and getting that out at all.
Kickboxing, not directly, but indirectly, yes, of course, you know, learning ways to kind of defend yourself. Because I've always been, I don't want to say a pushover, but always very accepting of, oh, you know, I forgive you and it's okay. And then you kind of end up getting walked on several right. times and realizing that it's not okay. And forgiving somebody and forgetting isn't probably a good idea all the time. And you have to learn how to set boundaries. So I just kind of was in this situation where I felt like, am I being crazy possessive? And am I having one of those, like, immature emotional experiences? Or is she crossing the line? And it was probably a bit of both, but it's the dynamic of going back and forth inside your head, knowing full well that you want to beat her up every time she does something. So, yeah. Nice. But, yeah, I mean, I do feel like you have to learn when to stand up for yourself. And hopefully women will be able, and people will be able to use the song for that.
Yeah, definitely.
The album is actually a process of going from partying and being this kind of freshly 21, like, all right, I can go to bars and drink, yes! to realizing the power of your mind and your spirit and your body and becoming an empowered kind of super chick. Oh, my man.